good morning, child. Do you need another music in it?
Bill Monroe, when he started out with Bluegrass Boys, wore plantation bosses' outfits. I mean, there was very little missing except for the bullwhip from the way they were dressed. And they were also dressed as men who rode horses. With the high boots and the jodhpur riding pants and the little hats and the necktie. I mean, they're right in there. And of course, that's a boss man's outfit. That is the captain's outfit. You know, who's ever's working in the fields is down below your heel there, you know? And you're riding through on your horse. And that's an image that had a big meaning in the South.
He told me the story several times about cutting the logs for the railroad ties. Back in these hills there around where he was raised, and cutting them with, you know, like hand saws or cross cut saws and axes, no chainsaws back then, you know, and hew those things out and throw them across the shoulder and carry them so far down the hill to a big old wagon that they hauled them out to wherever they had to go to with them. You know. He was strong. Strong character.
I'm an old mule skinner down old Kentucky way. I can make any mule listen. I won't accept your pay.
We was getting pretty wet and cold, and we got the mules in the trailer, and time we got back to Bill's farm out of Goodlettsville there, it was dark. Bill said, go up in there and get them mules and bring me one at a time out here. So I went up in between them mules, and I'd get one of them, and I'd back him out, you know, and Bill would take him, and he'd lead him to the barn. I'd stand there and hold the door, shut the door on the trailer, one at a time. There was seven mules, and the last one way up there in the nose of the gooseneck, he said, go up there and get that mule. I went up there, and that mule turned around on me, and when he seen that open door, here he went just dragging me. And just as soon as he got out of there, Bill's hand come up there and got that lead rope. He said, Billy Joe, you have got to let that mule know who the boss is. And he jerked his head around there like that. And I swear he stood flat-footed and kicked that mule in the bottom of the jaw so hard it sounded like he busted a watermelon. I mean, his leg come up, it looked unnatural. Straight. I couldn't raise my leg up that high back then. Kicked him. He said, you got to let him know who the boss is, you know. What can I
give? If you think back to 1936 and the Monroe brothers, and then you think that, and the Monroe brothers were really big, but then you think after that, Bill Monroe, Grand Ole Opry star at 28 years old, and how great he played an instrument that nobody had played great up to that point. Nobody. I like to put it this way. Bill Monroe was great before anybody else was good. He was so far ahead of everybody else, singing, playing, conceptually.
Bill, when I was with him, Mule Skinner Blues was one of his big numbers. When the audience would get lagged, I'd say, Bill, you're gonna have to lay the mule on them. And he'd always, when he'd play that, they'd.
When I went to work with Bill, you know, the faster the better. And if we played a waltz 3,000 miles an hour, it's too slow. And I just liked to buzz with it. And Bill taught me patience about how every tune has its own speed, its own time.
Some of the greatest musical moments of my life was when I'm playing a fiddle solo, and Bill would take that rhythm mandolin up like this in my right ear. And there's nothing better to play to than that. No drummer, no bass player, nothing. That was it. He was the greatest rhythm player to ever play rhythm.
He would feature everybody. Yeah, he was also very democratic. Yeah, it wasn't just me, Bill. It was everybody in the band, and he would call people's names on the Opry, and they became known that way. Yeah.
The early music that he learned from his folks was timing, right, and gospel singing at the church he went to up there, Holiness and Methodist. And, but his mother now could sing and play. She played the fiddle, and she played the accordion. But he said she would go through the house sometimes, and she'd play a few licks on the fiddle and go back to cooking beans or whatever she was doing. Come back and play a little bit more on it. And just loved it. Loved it. And his the Vandiver side is the ones where the music came from.
I see. So that was his inspiration for learning the old fiddle tunes.
It was, and his timing, and his making sure that the old melody stayed in the song. Mm-hmm. He believed in that. That's what he was taught. And so that stayed with him. And then he met this black man that taught him some blues, that he loved that.
An old black man would ride the train to Rosine, guitar player named Arnold Schultz. And Bill learned a lot from him when he was a boy, you know, living with Uncle Penn.
And he talked about his Uncle Penn Vandiver, who was a Scottish fiddler, and played all of the Scottish fiddle tunes. And so that was an element, the Celtic roots of the fiddle music that he grew up with. And then he worked in the fields with black folks out in the farm fields. And when they would work, they would sing, and they'd do chants, and they would sing harmonies. And Bill learned to sing harmonies that way. And he learned inflection of the voice, you know, how to make the voice more expressive for a certain things. And so that was part of what went into his music. And then the old-time country music, like Carter Family, that was an element of what went into bluegrass.
I'm working on a building. I'm working on a building for my Lord.
Then there was Jimmy Rogers from Meridian, Mississippi, the blue yodeler. And he was the first man that came up with the Mule Skinner Blues. It's a working man's song in a way. It's like it is a statement of Bill's power, and maybe it just appealed to him on so many levels, you know, that he had to take it from good morning, Captain, good morning, child. Do you need another Mule Skinner? Down on your new mud line, yodelate. Now Bill got a hold of it, you know, it's rock and roll. Good morning, Captain. Good morning, Shine. Do you need another Mule Skinner down on your new mud line? Then Bill had to outdo Jimmy Rogers. Yodelay. He made it his own, you know. He was the captain, and he was the Mule Skinner, right? He's going to crack that whip. He's going to drive that team, yeah.